Welcome to part 3 of fibroids types. Today we are breaking down submucosal fibroids. You will understand what they are, their causes, symptoms, diagnosis, and how they can be managed. Let's begin by understanding what they really are. Submucosal fibroids are a type of uterine fibroid located beneath the endometrium. They are non-cancerous tumors that protrude into the uterine cavity and are considered the most symptomatic type of fibroid due to their effects on the endometrial surface. Their exact cause is still unknown, but estrogen and progesterone play a key role in stimulating fibroid growth, whose risk factors include family history on fibroids, ethnicity with higher prevalence in African American women, obesity, and high BMI. Another key risk factor is age, which is most common in women between 30 to 50 years old. Do you know that submucosal fibroids represent 5 to 10% of all uterine fibroids? Actually, up to 70 to 80% of women are affected by fibroids by the age of 50, but not all are symptomatic. Submucosal fibroids are associated with heavy menstruation bleeding, which often lead to anemia. Other symptoms include intermenstruation bleeding, pelvic pain or pressure, infertility or recurrent miscarriage due to distortion of the uterine cavity, and fatigue from anemia. Next up is diagnosis, which relies on pelvic exam and imaging using ultrasound and MRI for detailed mapping, while hysteroscopy and sonohysteroscopy might be used if cavity distortion is suspected. By the way, treatment depends on symptom severity, fertility goals, and fibroid size or location, whose options range from observation if asymptomatic to hormonal treatments using oral contraceptives, progestins, gonadotropin-releasing hormone agonists, and tranexamic acid for heavy bleeding. Other options include minimally invasive procedures like uterine fibroid embolization to shrink fibroid, while myomectomy is preferred for women desiring fertility. On the other hand, hysterectomy is applied if fertility is not a concern. In conclusion, submucosal fibroids are less common but highly symptomatic fibroids. Therefore, with the right diagnosis and treatment, they are manageable. If you are experiencing symptoms, consult your healthcare provider for a personalized plan. If you are interested in learning more about women's health topics, check out our other videos and share with someone who needs clarity. Thanks for watching. My name is Skylar.